1991 complete with fake fur,
makeup,
and full-on glam attitude.
The four were childhood friends in Wales. So when their guitarist Richie Edwards went missing totally mysteriously in 1995, they were shattered.
So what happened?
No one knows. Richie's never showed up. No one knows if he's dead or alive, and the group has decided to go on. They have a new album called Everything Must Go, and if you listen to the words, you can hear that mystery still in the music. Was it fairly emotional for you guys to when you first started playing again without Richie?
To be honest, you know, to a certain degree, yeah, but I think we kind of dealt with a lot of that baggage way before we started playing, you know, because of course there's a big gap between the actual event of Richie and actually playing a concert. There was a big gap, and I think we dealt with a lot of that stuff way before we started working again. And we had to, because it was much more personal. You know, that's what people don't really understand. You know, the hardest things were the personal things, because we've been friends since we were young. So, like, actually playing and recording weren't as hard as actually dealing with the more personal stuff.
The 80s in England was just like one big walk down the graveyard. It was just so drab and boring and unexciting. They said nothing at all. Whereas we say, take good counts.
When we released the first single, Design for Life, yeah, there was a definite sense of people just really being almost like a morbid curiosity, you know. Just people actually thinking, what are they going to do now, you know, kind of how are they going to manage now? So there's a definite, like, you know, macabre sense of curiosity around our first single. I was definitely aware of that, yeah. But it kind of worked to our advantage, to be honest. I wish I had.
Offend you, but you've certainly changed. I mean, I know just from looking at your photographs and stuff like that, you used to be much more outrageous.
When we were young, you know, we were much more contentious. We were much more pretentious as well, you know, much more confrontational. And you can't really buy that. As you said, that's kind of what you inherit with your youth, you know. And as soon as you get older, you get disinherited. And you've just got to accept that. And you've just got to accept what you are. And kind of a certain graceful eloquence then comes into play, perhaps. Like hold ourselves to so many rules which we had actually created for ourselves. You know, we were like a manic street preacher. We weren't human beings, so to speak. And I think we've granted ourselves a bit of human grace now, and therefore, like I said, I think, you know, there's a lot more comfort within the music, and it's easier to live within the music. And perhaps, you know, we sound more like a band now rather than actual four raging kind of, you know, kind of, you know, individuals kind of like going off into soliloquies about this and that, you know. Perhaps much more of a band, ironically enough. actually. They used to be so confrontational. I think Nick has just started writing about things that inspire him, you know, which is something I never thought would have happened. But it's really good that has happened, you know. You can only rage against something for so long. And I suppose you've just got to try and get some kind of positive kind of affirmation in your life sooner or later. Otherwise, you'll end up kind of combusting, I suppose.
Show me your arm.
Eating very well. The National Service does a pretty good job in Britain these days. Perfect.
It always comes out nice and red. He has a bottle of vodka that brings it out in the blood.
Really?
Really does. The scar comes up really nice.
We all grew up with each other. You know, we've all known each other since we were young. So it's not as if we're just people that are in a band with each other just for convenience sake. I'm not in a band just because Nick can play bass and John can play drums and Nick can write lyrics. I'm in a band with them because they were my best friends when I was young. In at all, because when we first came to be, it was the Manchester thing was happening, and then it's kind of the shoegazing thing, then Seattle came over, and then last year was the year of Britpop. We weren't releasing a record last year, so kind of, you know, we've always kind of lived in our own little vacuum, and I'm quite relieved about that, because it means that we never get dragged down in the undertow of a movement that dies. You know, we always kind of, you know, we can always kind of pretty manage to outlive anything.
Bounce along the top of the
line. Yeah, just kind of like a flotsam.